This afternoon marks the final Coliseum appearance for the 1997 Trojan football seniors.
Saying goodbye is never easy, but saying thank you is. Now we show our appreciation to the Trojan senior class of 1997. They understood what this day and their careers meant.
My USC experience has been everything to me. I mean,
we play as a family, and that's a big thing. We taught to respect others, which is important too. I believe coming in here, you learn these values, which are important in life.
I don't know, ever since I was just a young kid, I was just always wanted to come here.
The camaraderie, the team, it's not just a team, it's a family. That saying, you're a Trojan for life, is really accurate.
You've meet this school, the people around here, how we are a family once you in, and once you leave, they always keep the tradition of Trojan for life.
Washington. How did he do that? Touchdown, Trojans. And how did he do that? Going to be second down and seven. They gave him 3 yards on first down. Pitch this time to LaVale Woods again, and Woods cuts back, has the first down, breaks into the open. It's going to be a foot race at the 40, midfield, needs one block. At the 30, the 20, the 10, cuts back, touchdown, Trojans, 96 yards, and the tenor of this game is reversed just like that.
Three receivers to the short side, Dean is back to throw, steps up, in the air, long downfield, going to be a jump ball in the end zone, tipped away, intercepted, picked off by Kelly.
Washington over the top, touchdown. And so the final seconds will tick away, and this game will go into the history books with the final score of Southern California 41, Northwestern 32.
Things started to bounce the way of the Trojans. Notre Dame fumbled a Jim Wren punt. And again a Trojan, this time Anthony Volson was there to recover deep in Notre Dame territory. From there, Otten wasted no time in finding an open Chris Miller in the end zone, and the Trojans had a TD.
In the end zone, touchdown, Miller.
The Irish came roaring back. Autry Denson went 9 yards for a touchdown. An unsportsmanlike penalty would play a big part in the game. The Irish would be penalized on the subsequent kickoff. But for the extra point, it was hooked left and it missed. And Notre Dame was leading 20-12 with time winding down. Brad Otten then methodically marched the Trojans down the field and in position to tie the game. Delon Washington finished off the drive with a spectacular jaunt into the end zone, and the Trojans were down by two.
The Irish 15, they give it to Washington. Outside, inside at the five. Touchdown, USC, as Washington takes it right up the middle. Into the end zone, Washington gets the two, and the game is tied.
And so the Trojan defense stiffened and came up big once again. Third and seven at the Notre Dame 36. Big Darrell Russell puts pressure on Paulus and sacks him for one of the big plays of the game. So for the first time in the series history, Notre Dame and USC went to overtime. Notre Dame won the toss, elected to go on defense. Brad Otten quickly hit Rodney Sermons for 14 yards to the Irish 11. And then Otten again to Sermons, this time for the touchdown.
Third down at the five. Otten to throw, gets a rush past Sermons. Touchdown, USA!
After the extra point, SC was up 27-20. And the pressure on Notre Dame to put it in the end zone. On second and four from the 24, Sammy Knight dropped Denson for a five-yard loss. And then SC to hold again on third and nine. Paulus pass incomplete, so it's fourth down, do or die for Notre Dame. With Paulus going back to pass, Mark Cusano made the final big play of the year for USC.
This crowd at the Coliseum is alive. Paulus back to throw, sets, looks, throws, and is batted down. The Trojans beat Notre Dame in overtime.
6:38 to go in the first period. Fox gives the ball to Washington. He's into the end zone. The Trojans have scored.
Ooh, I hope we get a replay of that. That was a great trap.
Big rush on Fox. That throws in the end zone. Touchdown. Pass is thrown. Pass is caught. And with it is R.J. Sauert. And despite Notre Dame's defensive strategy and the Trojans' own problems at the third and goal situation at the three, why, Fox hits Sauert, and this game is a point away from being tied. Good snap. He's back to throw. Steps up. Fires it downfield. Tip. Intercepted. Cusano's got it at the 45. At the 50. 45, 40. 35, 30. And down at the Irish 28-yard line. Is Mark Cusano destined to go through SC football as a Notre Dame killer? Ran to hold. Maybe to win it. The snap, it's down, he hits it. It is long enough.
It's good.
It is good. It is good. Adam Abram kicks his second field goal of the afternoon, 37 yards this one, and SC leads 20-17 with 1:05 remaining in the ball game. For the first time this afternoon, the Trojans are on top. It's Paulus again in the shotgun. Low snap. He's back to throw. Sets, looks, gets hit, gets dropped. Back at the 31-yard line. 7 seconds. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's all over. It's all over. The Trojans win it. 20-17.
I'll probably say the biggest play I'll probably remember that I've been involved in was the play against Notre Dame. Overtime play. Oh yeah, felt good.
I think one of the best memories I have of SC is, you know, our first win against Illinois when I was here my junior year, and it's just the first time where, you know, we were able to put it together as a team, and you know, Coach Robinson gave me the game ball, and that was one of the probably the first time I really felt like I was contributing here.
Favorite memories beating Notre Dame and Notre Dame. Going to the Rose Bowl my sophomore year.
My first play, my favorite play would probably be my onside kick against Cal, and then my second against Stanford, and probably my first pass reception.
The one thing that's gonna stand on my mind, it's not one play, it's each and every play that I was in there, because whenever I was in there, I felt like that I was contributing to the team's success in ways other than scouting, and that made me proud.
It was a play of mine, my first interception ever in the Arizona State game when I caught the ball and almost scored. I got tackled by the quarterback, but things happened.
I have to say probably my favorite play or anything that ever happened in a game was 2 years ago at Notre Dame. I mean, game didn't turn out as well as we thought, but you know, I got a kickoff return, and it was pretty cool getting to touch the ball finally and doing that, and took it back 14 yards, and I'd have to say that was probably the biggest play in my career.
When I was a freshman, we played Notre Dame and we tied them 17-17, and I was young and I enjoyed playing football, and I got a sack against Ron Paulus, and you know, as somebody that you grew up watching, Notre Dame, Lou Holtz. And it was like a third down conversion, and that was like my only sack of the year, and I think that's the biggest memory or something that sticks out in my USC career to me.
Probably my favorite moment would be winning the Rose Bowl my sophomore year, won a Pac-10 title, and I'd always hear about playing in the Rose Bowl, watching the Rose Bowl, and actually being there, and then not just being there, but winning the game was probably the greatest feeling I've had.
My freshman year, like my first hit, I mean, that was like my first camp. It was against Cal. I mean, we were blowing them out and I got in. And then, you know, they threw a little swing pass out on the flat, and then I just like gave them a little bit. But I mean, that was good. And then it just rose from there, you know. Then the Rose Bowl the following year. And then like, you know, games against Oregon, playing against Florida State. I mean, I can't have a particular moment that sticks out.
Say one of my favorite memories was winning the Cotton Bowl in Texas in 95. we really beat them pretty bad, and you know, it was something that I'm proud of, and you know, it was great.
Every memory have to be going to the Rose Bowl, but you know, that's the greatest accomplishment we've had since I've been here. The biggest thing about that I remember is that after halftime they had the onside kick. Now, I usually don't get too excited about anything, but when I saw him line up and kick the ball, it seemed like it took forever.
I think the favorite thing I remember is the Notre Dame game last year. I mean, it was a real emotional victory. We haven't beat them in a real long time, so I think that'd probably be my favorite thing.
Favorite memory, Oregon State game, Rose Bowl year. 2 minutes left on the clock, the silly way. I think that was a big memory for me, being the guy that was close to rushing for 1,000 yards and on the Division I level, showed that I had that good side of me to be able to play in a big Rose Bowl game that you always dreamed about playing in.
My favorite play is when I scored the touchdown in the Rose Bowl. That was just because ever since I was a little kid, I've always dreamed about it. I've always told my mother, my family, my friends. I mean, you can go back and ask any of them. I always said I was going to be scoring a touchdown in the Rose Bowl. The only thing I was wrong about was it wasn't against Michigan. I always thought it'd be against Michigan, but it was against Northwestern, but I don't care. I got the score.
There are memories of games, of practices, of rallies, and there are also thoughts of those who matter.
I mean, one person I obviously want to thank is Coach Barry and everything that he's given me. You know, he was always really hard on me when I was younger, when I was, you know, coming into being a player and really growing into being a football player. And him being hard on me really helped me with my game and helped me as being a man.
I'd say, you know, my biggest supporter is probably my mom. You know, she's been to every game. She follows me wherever I go. And, you know, anytime I've needed anything, she's been right there with me.
I'd like to thank my family for supporting me. I came out here, didn't know anybody in California, and basically went out on a limb, came out on my own. And I'd also like to thank the coaching staff and the people here at USC, Coach Robinson, Coach Thurman, the defensive coaches, as well as the offensive coaches, really opened up and helped me feel at home.
I mean, there's so many people you can thank. It's like anytime you get to a certain level, it's good to look back and think about the people who helped you get there. And you know, people in my family, I like to thank my mom, my family, my brothers have always been great for me. My girlfriend's been a source of support.
Out of every person here that I've ever met at SC, I have to thank Coach Barry. He's been a great person to me and given me many chances. And, you know, I owe that guy a lot, and he's given me everything I could ever ask of, like a second dad.
My mother has been the most inspirational person since I've been here. She always kept me going when times were hard, and it didn't seem like I was gonna play anymore. I was hurried all the time.
I like to thank the whole coaching staff here, Coach Rob and everybody, just for giving me a chance, you know, to prove that I can play football.
The number one person that's been influencing in my life has to be James Strong, because he helped me, took me under his wing in order for me to get where I was today. He didn't have to do what he does because I wasn't a recruited athlete, but because of his kindness and giving heart, he worked with me.
I'd like to thank Janice Henry, my academic counselor. She's been like a mother to me from the day I walked in here. And that's something that a lot of players, a lot of people who go on to college, they need someone who's gonna play a role, you know, as being, you know, someone that really cares about you. And she's played that role a great deal.
Definitely my mother, my parents, my mom, she just, since day one, I mean, it's always just been me and her. And until she got remarried to my stepfather, who's a great guy, man also. And, you know, she's just always been there for me. I mean, she's just like just number one in my heart. I mean, just my mother.